ICT adoption among small and medium enterprises in Kenya stands at 54%, according to a recent Business Ready Index by Safaricom, which was conducted on 1,200 SMEs across the country. We are now joined by Rita Okuthe, Director for Business Enterprise Unit at the company.
You conducted an index that focused on 181,000 businesses, SMEs across 21 counties in Kenya. Tell us what this survey was all about. What were you looking for?
So we were looking for SMEs that were ready to consume technology products, because that's our core area of business. And we're also trying to conduct a census of SMEs to make sense of the numbers, because there are several numbers of SMEs that are pandied across the country. So if you read the local dailies and you read reports, the numbers range from 1.8 to 1.6 million. But a lot of these would be small enterprises, sort of mom and pop setups. If you go to the company registrar, in Kenya they have about 500,000 registered businesses. If you speak to the Kenya Revenue Authority, then there are 300,000 businesses that pay tax on an ongoing basis. So out of that subset, we wanted to be clear how many of these businesses are ready to consume technology for business use.
Now, in terms of uptake of ICT, you found out that SMEs uptake is about 54 to 100. Is that a good place to be, consider that Kenya is, you know, the hub of technology in East Africa?
I don't think it's a good place to be. Because if you think of the value that SMEs bring into the economy from an employment standpoint, from a revenue standpoint, it's not a good place to be. The bulk of our populace is employed in the SME sector. So out of those 300,000 businesses we talked about, only a little under 1,947 are what we call big corporates with 150 employees plus. So it tells you that the bulk of our businesses are SMEs. Now, if half of them are digitized, it means that there's a whole host of business that's going on that we have no view of. Because what technology does, it helps you to understand the businesses, their rate of growth, their key issues. But if you don't have the basic technology in place, then it becomes very, very difficult for you to be able to establish what these businesses need to move forward. And so for me, 54% is not good.
When you looked at these SMEs, what kind of technology is lacking, you know, and what that maybe informs what you'll be selling to them in the near future?
So if you speak to the average SME, SMEs understand that they need technology. They probably want it, but it's too expensive for them. That's number one. And then number two, a lot of them are there to make money. So they don't want to invest in some big CTO who'll come and tell them how to manage their technology. So what you find with a lot of them, they're keen to have the technology, but they want technology that works for them. They don't want complicated things. So if you go there and you're trying to sell, you know, fixed link connectivity, MPLS, you lose them. They want to track the performance of their business, they want to track the performance of their stock, they want to track the performance of their employees, and ultimately they want to know how much money is coming into this business, what are my costs, and how do I make real profit. So SMEs are interested in managing their businesses, not managing technology. And so we want to take away the pain of managing technology, manage the technology on their behalf so that they can focus on managing their businesses and satisfying their customers.
The index found out that there are certain industries where uptake of technology by SMEs is not big, like hospitality and agribusiness. Is it a matter of perception?
So it's not that they don't need technology. I think it's two things. We haven't developed technology that helps them to run their businesses better, because every business needs a specific solution. What you give to a bank is not what you give to the agribusiness farmer. So I think it's two-way. They haven't seen the need for technology, but also we as technology experts haven't developed those solutions, which is what we're doing now with the Ready Business.
In terms of investment, for example, CapEx, how much is Safaricom investing in enabling technology for SMEs? We can look at the previous 1 year.
In terms of CapEx, we've invested quite a bit, especially in our fixed infrastructure. So fiber, high-speed connectivity becomes very important. Working with partners to develop applications, making our core network more resilient, building cloud and hosting solutions. I mean, all that I think would be in excess of a billion to 2 billion shillings that we've invested just to make sure that we have the right underlying infrastructure to overlay some of these propositions we are talking about.
Yeah. All right. Now, SMEs are a very big part of this economy. I know, not just directly, but even if you look at indirect in terms of jobs creation. Over 75% of the people are working within these SMEs. Just the bigger picture, what would you see as the role of technology in this, making sure that SMEs are powered by technology? What kind of broader effect do you see?
I think technology will make our SME segment more efficient. More efficient in terms of understanding their business, understanding their customers, giving their customers a better experience, optimizing their employees and the output. And finally, being able to track also their revenue and you know, their own performance as a business. So these are the three areas that I see technology making a big difference. The second thing is, you know, technology allows you to run your business from wherever you are. So you don't have to be seated there. If everything is on a database and you can see it, you're able to run your business more efficiently even when you may not be physically there. So I think that's the second value that we bring. And I think the third value, I think, is just increasing the adoption of technology as a whole. Because if the SME segment that employs 75% of our populace is not up to speed in technology, then the penetration of technology by effect will not grow.